welcome to another trip report. And good morning as well from Lausanne in Switzerland. It is 3:30 a.m. and I'm about to get a train into Geneva so that I can catch a flight from Geneva to Madrid with Iberia. Today's plan is not just to fly into Madrid, but also to connect through there with Iberia Express, the budget arm of Iberia, and on to Gran Canaria in the Canary Islands. That'll be the subject of a future video. Today I'm just focusing on the Geneva to Madrid leg. The reason that I'm actually in Lausanne is because Geneva as a city is completely booked up because of a car show that's going on. So unless I want to pay an arm for a leg, I wasn't going to get a room there. So I'm waiting for the first regional train of the day into Geneva and onto the airport. Should get me in there around about 5 a.m, which gives me 2 hours to spare before my 7 a.m. departure. I think I've just found my tolerance for early starts. I know I've had some pretty early alarms, but a 3 a.m. alarm this morning, that is something different. Also, not only is it 3 a.m. here, but I have to factor in the fact that it's an hour ahead of the UK. So in real terms, it's a 2 a.m. alarm call for me. Oh, there's a freight train going through. Awesome, look. I've been in about 20 minutes, that's the only train that's come through. Anyway, let's get on with the trip report. In case you're wondering why I'm wearing a baseball cap so early in the morning, it's about an hour into Geneva on the train. I'm gonna use this, tip this over my eyes and get some sleep. Let's go. Geneva Airport. It is just before 5:30 in the morning and it is really, really deserted here. In fact, the business class lounges haven't opened yet. Normally, as an Iberia business class passenger, with the ticket I've got, I'd be able to get inside the British Airways lounge here, which opens at 6 a.m. I can't really wait until 6 a.m, so I'm going to use my priority pass to get into the Swiss lounge, which I think is a superior lounge anyway. Really need something to drink, an orange juice, a coffee, and maybe something to tide me over till I get on the plane. Expecting to get some sort of breakfast on the aircraft. The flight's just over 2 hours long, so I'm hoping for something substantial there. I get loads of questions asking how I'm able to do what I do. Mostly people ask from a kind of financial perspective or even from a work-life balance perspective, because I do have a full-time job as well. I do all of this on my days off. One of the big pieces of advice I can give anyone who's looking to pursue traveling like I do as a hobby is to find out what your level is in terms of early starts. You've really got to be a morning person to get into this game. I could have traveled a bit later at about 2 p.m. today. That would have given me a connection of about an hour in Madrid and then flying down to Gran Canaria in the evening. That would have meant, however, that the second flight would have been in the dark. Night flights don't tend to do so well on YouTube. There's a lot less to see, and the ambience is just not really there. I've always found that my daytime flights do a lot better in terms of view. So taking two daytime flights today, always look forward to the early morning flights as a chance of getting a decent sunrise on camera. So let's go into the Swiss lounge and I'm gonna grab something to eat.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
During the flight, we will be providing the gastronomy service designed for this flight.
Que a partir de este momento queda abierto nuestro servicio de la tienda a bordo, donde podrá disfrutar de promociones.
Thank you. Goodbye.
That's it, guys. Welcome to Madrid. I hope you enjoyed the flight. I certainly did, and it was great to get a nice civilized breakfast along with a decent coffee traveling over the Pyrenees. That was a really lovely experience. Anyways, if this announcement will let me, I'm going to close the trip report here, and I'll see you next time.